Welcome to the Worship Center in Bryans Road, Maryland, where Jesus is saving lives, saving souls, and saving futures. Now here's Dr. Steve Davis with wisdom tips, life treats, and gold nuggets from God's Word.
Greetings, everyone. As always, I'm so grateful for the opportunity to speak to you. You know, we're talking these days about the power of the words that we speak. And even if we're considered a nobody in this world, God has given us the ability to speak words that can bring powerful effects and results in your life and in the lives of other people. And you probably don't realize how important and powerful that is. Your words can change your life for the better or make it worse. They can make you more successful, more fulfilled, more joyful. Or they can bring failure, dissatisfaction, and sorrow. Your words that you speak can make you more like Jesus and bring a blessing to people. Or they can make you more like that other fellow and bring problems. Jesus said in Matthew 12, verse 35, a good person produces good things from the treasury of a good heart, and an evil person produces evil things from the treasury of an evil heart. So on the inside of you, in your heart, the inner you, is the basis of what can be on the outside or in the natural realm. What does that mean? It means that what you say reflects what's in your heart. And what's in your heart determines in many ways what you can experience in your life, as well as what you bring to other people. And that's the basis of so much, both the good and the evil that we see in the world. People who are driven by what's good, they want to do good and bring good to other people, and they do exactly that. And people who are driven by evil, by greed, hatred, and violence, bring that evil and the pain and violence to other people, victimizing them and destroying people from the evil that's in their own hearts, as it's brought from the inside of them to the outside. And that's why it's so important what we put in our hearts, what we meditate on, and what we think on. Now, before we go any further, I want to invite you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Give us a thumbs up, and then share this video with a friend who might be blessed by these simple Bible truths that we put out each week. Just one a week, so you never get overloaded by them, and you can easily keep up. So, as I was saying, on the inside of you are the valuables, the treasure, the good things that you need for living and moving ahead on the outside in the natural world. What you need on the outside will be supplied by what you have on the inside, where your spirit is, where your heart is. Your best riches aren't on the outside, but on the inside. They're beneath the surface. People can't see them from the outside because they're on the inside. They are in seed form on the inside and are brought to the outside as you think on them, speak them, and act on them. When God made the earth, He didn't put the precious metals and jewels on the surface of the earth. He put them beneath the surface on the inside. And they're all found beneath the surface. And sometimes you have to dig pretty deep to find them. And it's the same with us. The real valuables are on the inside. We're made, the Bible says, out of the dust of the earth. And it also says we have treasure in earthen vessels. You have riches and treasures that are stored up on the inside of you. And things you've learned, things that have been taught to you, ideas that you have, skills and talents you may have, but have never acted on, never developed, but they're still there, waiting to be brought forth. You know, sometimes you access these treasures, these gifts, by discovering them and beginning to learn more about them, developing them, talking about them, practicing them, reading about them, all of that. And that's one way. And it might be something that just keeps coming up, like maybe something that someone does well and it clicks with you and you say, I want to do that. I want to learn that. I want to be part of that. And that's the beginning for many people. And sometimes those treasures beneath the surface come up through something you never planned or maybe didn't even want. Just like on a natural earth, there might be a flood or an earthquake. And afterwards, you find that there are treasures that are there that were beneath the surface all along, but now they're brought to the top, where they can be discovered. And you might be in a situation that you didn't choose, but because of it, you discover strengths that you never knew you had. You might find that you have a certain gift or certain skills or talents and ways to help people. Another way to find the gift can be like this. You might remember sometimes in the old movies, old cowboy movies, people panning for gold. They'd go to a mountain stream with a pan that has a screen on the bottom, and they'd start sifting the pebbles and sand from the bottom of the stream into the pan and swirl it around. Sometimes they'd find gold nuggets amongst the sand and pebbles. The spring that causes the stream had brought it up from the earth where it had been hidden. The flowing water washes away the dirt, bringing the gold to the surface. And in the same way, many times, it's through prayer and worship, through spending time with God in His presence, that you begin to discover gifts that He's put into your heart. It's one reason I like to spend so much time in prayer, to bring His gifts and valuables that are brought to the surface by that living water, the springs of living water. And you can be sure that God has put treasure on the inside of you as a gift. Maybe a little ability that you see on the surface reveals something bigger on the inside. That little bit of undeveloped talent that you have is connected to a greater ability that you haven't even imagined yet. And instead of looking to the outside for answers, we can start using those abilities and opportunities and solutions we already have on the inside. Use what you already know. Many times your biggest problems can be solved by what you already know. And it has to do with being faithful in the little things, of using what you have. Romans 10 and verse 17 says, "So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ." And God's word will produce the faith you need to get your needs met. You probably already know Proverbs 18 and verse 21, where it says, "The tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit." And in many ways, your life is shaped by what you put into your heart, what you look at, what you spend time with, what you watch, what you read, what you think on. And when the Word of God is in your heart, your life is shaped by the Word of God. Romans 10 verse 8 says, but what does it say? The Word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. He said, that's the Word of faith that we proclaim. And it's talking about believing in your heart and confessing with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and receiving salvation. And Jesus said in Matthew 12, verse 34, "For out of the abundance or fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks." So what we fill our heart with determines what we believe and what we say and what we'll act on. So we want to be sure to get our hearts filled with the right things. I can tell you, coming to church once or twice a week and listening to a sermon or watching a couple of Christian videos isn't going to counteract the hours and hours that some people spend in their toxic online activity. Hours at a time, every day. James 3 and verse 4 says that a ship may be huge and powerful, but it's steered by a small rudder, and that's what determines the direction of the ship. And in verse 5, it says the tongue is the same way. It's not the wind that determines which way the ship goes, but the rudder. And your tongue is like a rudder that directs the course of your ship or your life. What you say is based on what's in your heart or what you let into it. And if you let the Word of God in, your words will be the God kind of words and will bring the wisdom, the justice, the healing, cleansing, and forgiveness that God wants to bring. God says in Isaiah chapter 57, verse 19, that He creates the fruit of the lips. And He goes, "Peace, peace to those that are near and those that are far." And when you speak the words of God, He creates the substance of the things you're speaking. He's given us His words, His wisdom, His righteousness, His justice to bring to those around us and all those who are within the sound or the reach of our voice. And so many people nowadays are always speaking about what they don't want and who they don't like and what they're afraid of and who they're mad at and what's wrong with everything. And when they do that, they seem to always have problems on top of problems. They're speaking problems and getting the fruit of it in their lives. They speak division and bitterness and hatefulness, and it takes them to that place and situation in their lives, and they live it. And I want to tell you that even a little bit of the Word of God that you speak has power to change the course of your life. Even though you might be driven and tossed by fierce winds of opposition, your tongue is like a rudder. It directs where you end up and where you go in life. It sets the direction for you, and it'll take you wherever you need to go. And you know, many people run aground or adrift in life because of the kinds of things they think on or meditate on, and then as a result, the kind of things they say. And you have to bridle or harness your mouth not to speak just any old thing because you're mad or bitter or whatever. We have to take responsibility for the words we're speaking and putting out there. We need to control our thoughts and our mouths to set where we go in life and how the voyage will be for us. 1 Peter 3 and verse 10 says, "For whoever desires to love life and see good days, let him keep his tongue from evil and his lips from speaking deceit." That's what God said is needed for a good life, a long life, and for good days. And they don't just happen randomly while we're out there cussing and complaining and spewing hate. And there are many Christians who are carnally minded. The carnally minded person is what the Bible calls double-minded. They speak life and blessing sometimes, and then they turn right around and uproot that blessing by speaking negativity into their lives and their environment. Fear and lack and inferiority, poverty, ill health, anger, hatred, all these things that don't go with the blessing of God. And God says it shouldn't be like that. You know, we can have either blessing or cursing by the words of our mouths. And I want you to know that we have the power. You have the power of God. We have the power of His word and the power of our words. And we want to speak words of power, words that align with God's word, words that declare God's words. We want to speak words of power, words that bring life and not death. Words that bring unity, not division. Words that bring love, not hate. Words that bring peace, not strife. We want to speak words of power. Words that build up and not tear down. Words that heal, not hurt. Words that bless, not curse. We want to speak words of power. Words that shape our reality and influence others. Words that reflect God's love and His grace. Words that fulfill God's purpose and His glory. And we want to speak words of power and see God's power at work in us. Through us, among us, in our lives, in our families, in our homes, our communities, and in our world. And I want you to know that I'm praying for you, that God's blessing will be upon you, that the Holy Spirit will touch you and fill you with His love, His forgiveness, His goodness, and His cleansing. And always know this, we pray for you, our prayer team prays for you, all of our YouTube family, and we always ask you to pray for us. And I specifically ask you to pray for me. I always need prayer, and I always appreciate it. Thank you so much, and God bless.
We hope you were blessed, inspired, and challenged by what you heard today. And we pray that God spoke some inspired truths into your heart. This ministry is supported by your gifts and donations. If you'd like to help us spread the good news, you can give at our website, www.theworshipcenter.org, or you can text to give at 301-637-0777. It's easy and takes only seconds to set up. Thank you for listening, and God bless you and your family.